afternoon, everybody. Today we are up here in Yucca Valley, and check this out. It's not a lot, but there is snow on the ground. We just had like a torrential rainfall again. We've had so much rainfall lately, which is good. We need it. But yeah, we got all this rainfall, and it was cold enough up here to snow and actually close down the whole road because trucks were sliding out. But look at that. There is actually snow on the ground. That's insane. So we're actually coming here to pick up this box truck and take it to Fontana. So we're going to get this all hooked up here, and I'm going to show you how we do that. Look at all the snow. That's cool. I say all the snow. There's barely any snow. That's fun. All right, let's stare a second. Get turned around here. That's just crazy. Barely any snow. There's a little bit. It's kind of funny. Buddies back in the Midwest and say, oh, this is what this is all about, huh? Even though it's barely anything. It's so funny. It is currently 46 degrees, so not too bad. Cold for a desert rat, though. It's actually been like that this whole in the mornings, though. It's been that temperature. Okay, set the brake. Let's go ahead and put the PTO, control power. I'm actually gonna throw the lights on since we're here on the side of the road. Just because. How you doing?
Good.
What's this white stuff? I've never seen it before.
Huh?
I said, what's this white stuff? I've never seen it before.
No?
No, I have. Not down in the desert, though. Kind of crazy. Look at that. That's awesome.
Oh, this morning, it also is right here.
Really? So yeah. It melted all day?
Yep.
Wow. That's crazy. So it's leaking coolant?
Yeah, there's something in the top to the head.
Oh, okay. Gotcha. All right, well, we'll get you hooked up and then we're going to Fontana, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay. Apologies for the messy truck, guys. Like I said, we've been running in the rain and it's just been nonstop, so we haven't had a chance to get this truck all cleaned up yet. Back up a little bit, get it closer. Get there. It's cold for me. Bet you it was really cold this morning.
Yeah.
It's 46 right now. I'm sure it was, what, 30 something this morning? Oh, jeez. How heavy do you think? I guess it can't be more than 26. But. Wind chill. this spongy right here. So obviously the rotator is an option to use for this tow, but it would not be cost efficient to run the rotator 90 miles down the freeway. So we use this truck. But we did use the rotator today for a lift. That's probably the last video you guys saw. All right, so we'll extend out and grab onto the front axle in between the U-bolts. Looks like we're pretty lined up there too. That's good. Might need to slide that other one over just a touch. Yeah, a little bit. Internationals, if not all of them, unless someone removed it, have quick connects on the air tank. So we'll use a 25 foot hose and a quick connect specifically made. Ugh. So what do you guys put in these trailers? I mean the boxes.
Medical waste.
Medical waste. Oh, yummy.
Yeah.
So don't ask me to go inside.
Huh?
So don't ask me to go in there.
Okay.
All right, so hook our quick connect here to this fitting here. All right. Fender here. Ugh. Up over the tire. Go like this. Make sure we're big enough to go over that. Is now since I've been running the rotator a little bit more. So I'll do a red line to emergency. That's constant. Valve to supply air back there, so we'll hit red and that gives us air. All right, grab our tie down chains. Axle tie down chains, that's what we'll use to tie the axle down. Run this to here. This will supply air to the air tank. Let that air up for a bit. Then we'll climb up in the cab. Actually, we'll grab our safety chains. let the system air up and we'll grab the safety chains. Just let it air up fully. Now we'll pull the drive line real quick. First, always make sure there's tension, or there's no tension, so it's loose. In this case it is. Probably use a 3/8 on this one. It's pretty small. Yep, 3/8 is gonna do the trick. Put it on our impact gun. Zip these out. Spin that one. That bolt until it comes to the bottom. That should do it. So we will yank that one out of there. There we go. Sounds like a Volkswagen. Probably was. back, can't go forward, can't go up, can't go down. Put our driveline sockets back in the case. Grab all our tools. I've been keeping the impact in the rotator, so I just grabbed it, threw it in here. All right, bring it to us. Right there. Boom down. And I like to go over that, but in front of the tie rod, so you're not crushing the tie rod. Chain it there. Go up and over leaf. Pull tight, slide your chain like so, and then hook and hook. And I'll even, once we tighten up, I get rid of the slack. Grab our safety chain as well, go up over the leaf screw. Just get it kind of close, leave it for a second. So we gotta run our other set. Over, grab. Pull it tight. Tilt, and it tightens up our chains like so. And then I just take this tail end, put it like that so it's not gonna hit the ground going down the road. One more loop in here. Grab two short bungees for the safety chains. That was ice under my foot. I like to get it just above the ground. Then I go to here. Oh, I don't know what I was thinking. Yes, I forgot to keep my chain, or my safety chain bungees right there. It's all right though. This is wrapped around right there, so I'll just go like that. Alright guys, well I'm gonna put you up on the boom cam again, and we'll see you guys at the drop off, so enjoy the time lapse. right, everyone. Made it to the drop-off here. Their yard is extremely tight. No way you can get a heavy in there. So I'm going to drop it out here on the street. And they're going to yank it in with a forklift. Don't worry, I'm gonna extend it out some. I'm gonna push, like, extend it.
Okay.
All right, let's go ahead and get all our goodies off here. So heavy. You're gonna have to manhandle it when you get it in here because you won't be able to start it or else that drive shaft will spin. You're gonna have
yeah.
So don't start it.
No, start it right now. Just hope you can switch, and that's it. You're neutral.
Yep, there you go. And I'll leave the air tank filled up so you have air pressure.
Okay. Maybe the mechanic comes tomorrow, I don't know.
Hopefully.
Yeah.
I mean, that's all you gotta do is just throw that drive shaft in.
Just start leaking water, bro.
Can I get out going that way?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. You go to the go straight,
uh-huh.
Like this.
And then back onto the slover?
Back to the slover, yeah.
Okay. Okay. I have a strap on there holding a drive shaft, and I'm gonna take that off and put it and tie it up with wire.
Okay.
That way it's not dragging on the ground.
All right. You can use it the restroom or something.
I'm all right now. Thank you though. I appreciate that. See how it's tied up right here? I'm just gonna take some wire and tie it up and take my strap off.
Okay.
That way it's not dragging.
Gotta watch my eyes.
Okay, give it a snip.
Snip. Go over.
Alright, this is just some simple baling wire. Works really well for this. It was super easy. Oh, I just tied my own drive shaft and strap. Alright, that should do the trick. Drop our strap. There?
Yeah.
Okay. Alright, come up here and set the brake. And I always like to put the driveline bolts right there so they know. And I like to set the keys on top of it. That way they know. Connect this end so they still have air. There we go. Cap back on. Unclick this guy, unclick this guy, roll this one up nice and tight. By the way, I am wearing my guardian angel. That's the light that you saw when I was dealing with the drive shaft right now. Great little light, just clips right onto my helmet, provides safety lighting and scene lighting. Super versatile. All right, so I like to roll this hose up nice and tight, clip it to itself, and then it goes right here. It's my most used hose, 25 foot hose. It's the most versatile hose that I have, so I keep it right there for easy access. Unhook that guy. Go grab our light bar. Oh yeah, by the way, this has body parts in it. It has bio waste, but it has like amputation parts, basically, is what he said. I was like, oh, that's awesome. Good to know. So, yeah, it's got arms and legs and feet and hands and fingers. All the goodies. Yum, yum. I'm gonna get with my office and make sure we're all good to go, but we should be all right. This guy up. Glad I remember that. Guys, well, hopefully you enjoyed that video. As always, like, comment, subscribe. Thank you for watching. Let me know in the comments what you thought about the video, and we'll see you on the next one. So thanks for watching, guys. Stay tuned.